Hello and welcome to Custom Gamer. My name is Daz and this is the show where we talk about level design while playing cool maps. Happy New Year everybody, I hope everyone had a great Christmas and I hope you're all still alive after New Year. I took a little bit of a Christmas break from doing videos, so a little holiday for myself. It was very enjoyable. We're going to get back to it now because something has been released that is a little bit special. It's called The Horde of Zendar. It's by Sock, a man which, if you play Quake, you probably should recognize his name by now. He's released a slew of incredible single-player maps, and of course his In the Shadows stealth mod, which has been very well received by the community. This is the crown jewel, I think. This map has been a long time coming, and unfortunately, Sock has said that it's probably his last Quake release. I'm guessing he's still going to be working on In the Shadows, but for Q1SP, I think this is the last. Unless everyone bullies him. I've been trying. So, you've got this entire city to explore around. Lots of route choices, lots of key choices, loads of shortcuts to open up. It really does triple distill everything that makes Quake great into a single map. And a lot of people have been saying that this could be one of the greatest Quake maps ever released. And it's honestly very, very hard to argue with that assessment. I find it hard to find problems with this map. It does have a couple small things, but on the whole, it really is just absolutely fantastic. And it's just a pleasure to present it because honestly, when you run a little modding channel like I do, when gems like this come along, it's just fantastic to show them to people that perhaps haven't seen them yet. And I'm going to enjoy doing that today, so let's go and do it, shall we? So the map starts in true Sock fashion, with a kind of in-map skill select that is used in a lot of his other releases. Pro tip, you can find the Nightmare skill select by shooting the button on the wall here and going around here. I will not be playing Nightmare for this playthrough. We'll be doing hard, and the map is very hard on hard. It's nice to get a decent challenge. So you get this huge vista at the start here, which is absolutely incredible. Just want to sit and look at it for a couple of minutes. And the thing I like about Zendar is there's a lot of route choices, even in this first little area here. You have lots of choices about how you want to climb upwards. There's the very obvious just kind of walk up the mound here to get up, but there's also lots of routes that perhaps aren't obvious at first, but you kind of learn them as you play the map. You learn to look for these things, so you can actually climb up the ruins here to get up this side. Then the stonework here is slightly embossed, so you can jump up this as well. I mean, you can just go up the other side as well, but it's just a freedom of choice, I guess, for the player is very, very high in this map. If you come up the other way, there's actually a ring of invisibility, which would be handy a bit later on. Unfortunately, I don't think I use it to its fullest potential in this playthrough, but depending on which routes you take in the map, it could be useful. This is something that's kind of a hallmark of this map, really. There's so many different ways to play it. Like, it's almost like one video playthrough isn't enough. I'm not really worried about spoiling the map here because there's so many different ways you can go in it. I think everyone's going to play it slightly differently. So even if you watch this video, you're probably going to take a different route than I do, just purely because of the map's construction. So this is the main courtyard of the city. You'll be coming back here a lot. It's kind of a main hub, lots of spokes coming outwards, and mainly above this area. It's very, very vertical, the level design here. And this area, as you go through the map, it kind of slowly fills up with enemies, and by the time you get to the end of the map, there's just bodies everywhere. This is something that Sock liked a lot about this area. It really feels like you're killing a horde of enemies. Just kind of fitting considering the name of the map. So, like a couple of other Quake maps I've looked at recently, the height in this map is kind of a denotation of progress almost. The gold key, which is the main objective in this map, the gold key door is on the highest part of the map, and that is the one thing you do need to find in order to quote unquote finish the level. But there's actually multiple silver keys hidden all over the place, which are kind of side objectives, and you can pick up these keys whenever you find them, and then you can go and open any silver key door you wish. Depending on which one you open, you'll have different routes, you'll have different power-ups. There's even entire sections of map which you won't even see unless you open up all the silver key doors, which is really, really cool to see. And once you get up onto the rooftops, that's kind of the highest area of the map, and there's lots of kind of secrets and things to discover out there. You can see here Sock's demon door mechanic returns, so whenever you see a demon head on a door, it means that there's a secret to open it very close nearby. You can look around, see if you can find it. Another pro tip is that all the ammo on these plinths in the central area here actually respawn. And you'll probably be needing some decent ammo on this map, because there's a lot of combat. But it's all paced out very nicely. It's not just kind of massive horde combat all the time. There's a lot of really interesting scenarios where you have some cool monster combinations which produce interesting gameplay. So if you notice this button on the steps here, this is the Scampi secret. This is a little bit of a joke that was flying around on IRC that Sock decided to incorporate into the map. There's just a single spawn in this entire map and it's locked in a secret like that. Now all these streets I'm walking down here all have upper areas that you can get to as well. Again, the map is very, very vertical. Just about every single area has kind of multiple floors that aren't usually accessible at first. You have to kind of find a way up there, either through a secret or just through progression in the map. To kind of start out exploring the dregs around here and then slowly go upwards. And the visuals in this map are absolutely fantastic. Now, it's all classic id style. There's a couple of custom Sock textures in here, but for the most part it's just all classic id stuff. But just the build quality is superb, and the lighting as well. Absolutely fantastic. So you get a little bit of a horde here come out of this door. Now, I kind of like this fight because you have this long courtyard behind you that you have plenty of room to back up in. So it really does feel like the fights are tailored to the environments that you're fighting in. This horde here is obviously designed in such a way that you want to retreat back down this long alley while you're taking them out. Which works fairly nicely. There's the gold key up there. Again, the gold key is like the central piece here that you need to connect. There's another silver key door that we're going to explore a bit later on. This map's really interesting in the fact that when you complete the gold key area and you quote-unquote finish the map, you actually have a choice. You can just exit the level, or you can just go exploring in the city and find all the areas you missed on the way through, and there will be a lot of them on the first time through. I know on my first playthrough of this map I missed quite a few entire areas. So I like the use of the scrags here. Whenever you hear a scrag, you always tend to like look up to find out where it is, and it's a great way to get the player to look up, which is incredibly handy in this map because you just suddenly realise just how much more level there is above you that you just haven't seen yet. So we've opened up a little shortcut back to the status. This is like a little loop. If we had a silver key we could open this, but we're gonna have to come back here later. Grab the gold key. Now I've got to deal with the Shambler. A little bit low on ammo. Again, if you do find yourself short on ammo, you can just run back to the main area and grab some more from those respawning ammo packs. Very, very good idea. There's plenty of these shortcut lifts around the place as well that you can activate to get yourself back up to an upper level quickly. I like that a lot, because if you accidentally fall down off of one of these ledges, it could be pretty annoying to try and go all the way back up through the map, but there's plenty of these shortcuts that you can activate. You may have noticed here there's some more kind of brickwork here that you can climb up. There's actually a transparent stained glass window there, so we're gonna go in there. This is very, very tricky. I think precision, like movement and jumping like this, is very, very hard in Quake, especially when you play with always run on, like 99% of players do, I'm sure. And that's an incredibly failed jump. One thing that's really interesting to note about this map, I think, is that it's incredibly speed runnable, I think, because of the vertical nature of the layout and the fact that you get a grenade launcher fairly early if you take the right route. You can do some pretty crazy grenade jumps in order to subvert entire sections of map, or even just reach higher areas in a way that you're not supposed to, really. It's really, really nice. It's so open. You just have a lot of choice. Zoga's having a bad day. There's another silver key door there, which we can explore a bit later on. Now, if you remember, the gold key access is in the central atrium, so we could just go back there straight away, but I wanted to explore around here and pick up some more items, get some more weapons. And it's just incredibly fun to do so. You really do feel like you're exploring in this map. I think a lot of modern titles, they're kind of, they put icons all over a map, so you end up not really exploring, you're just kind of following a map around. Especially open world games tend to suffer from this. Like Skyrim is a great example, where you've got this giant continent to explore and everything's nicely labelled for you, so you can just walk from one interesting thing to the next. You never really feel like you're exploring anything. Whereas in a map like this, obviously it's a lot smaller in scale than something like Skyrim, but there's no kind of icons telling you where to go. You can just kind of, oh look, there's a ledge there, I bet I can get to it. And 9 times out of 10 you can. Which is really cool to see. Now we can go up here, which loops back into the area we were just in. And we can grab a silver key here. So again, this loops back to before we jump through the stained glass window. However, if you jump across here, there is a nifty secret. Now this is where the ring of invisibility would come in handy, I think, if you were taking this route, but I just decided to rocket jump back up. So now I've got a silver key and a gold key. I want to save the silver key for part of the map I definitely wanted to show in this video, so we're going to go there now. Just in case I derp it and don't find another silver key, decided to come this way first. This is the section of the map I completely missed on my first playthrough. It's got this huge gothic kind of courtyard here. And it's just this huge arena battle, which is really, really cool to find. Sock does this ambush really, really nicely. So there's a quad damage in the centre of the courtyard, so you know something's going to go down. Lots of foreshadowing there with the quad damage. But instead of just throwing absolutely everything at you at once, Sock tends to just let the enemies spill in. And it feels very natural doing so. They kind of jump off the ledges from all these different window ledges and, you know, doorways and everything. You don't really see them teleport in a lot. They just seem to naturally flow out of the environment at you, which is really nice to see. This courtyard looks fantastic as well. There's so much detail crammed in here, it's crazy, really. Just looking around to check if there's any demon doors or anything. I don't think there are around here. In this playthrough, I find, I think, 7 secrets out of, I think there's 11 in total. So there's probably still parts of the map I haven't seen, and I've played this thing like 10, 12 times now. Go and choose another silver key door to explore now. Go back to the one on the second level that I skipped over last time. So this one would have been early access to a Supernal gun if we'd come here first. I bet there's a secret around on that little wooden barrier. I just never went to check it. Always worth looking in this map, there's always stuff hidden all over the place. So here we are above the main area of the map here. For the most part, these areas do get repopulated very nicely. So you never really feel like the map's completely empty once you've cleared a section. There are a couple of areas where you'll look back in onto the main atrium and there'll just be enemies kind of sitting around waiting for a player to turn up. Which is a bit of a shame, especially when a lot of the areas in this map are kind of set up really nicely to avoid stuff like that. There's a couple of instances here where you just see enemies just kind of waiting around. I guess it's really, really hard to avoid stuff like that when you've got an open map like this, because it's really hard to predict where the player will come back to this area. So yeah, there are a couple of things like this where you can just kind of snipe enemies off in the distance, so they have absolutely no way to get back at you. Now we can go and explore the church area. This is another area that you can come straight away, but I just didn't open this door the first time round for some reason. Again, this is another area you can come to get an explosive weapon very early, which again will give you access to upper areas by the use of grenade jumps. You get a nice little ambush here as well when you pick it up. And again here, instead of enemies just kind of teleporting into the area, they're kind of jumping off the ledges above you, which feels really, really cool. That's something I don't really see a lot of maps do. You know, typically the path of the course in Quake is that if you're doing an arena like this, you just kind of teleport in waves of enemies. Or just have various doors open with enemies pouring out of them. Sox arenas just feel very, very natural. I just love the way enemies just kind of pour out of the environment rather than being teleported in. It's really, really nice. And if you check in all these cubby holes, there is in fact a lift up to a secret here, which is kind of cool. And the church is a really interesting area in that it opens up a lot of routes back into other parts of the level. And you can kind of explore around here a little and open up lots of routes. Yeah, we've cleared out most of this stuff because we've been here already, but there are a couple of areas we haven't been yet. Got another demon door secret here. Let's go and have a look at the gold key area, shall we? Now we've cleared out a lot of the bottom of the map. I don't know why I hit that button. I just guess I just love hitting buttons. So you've got these barricades around the edges of this area. You can actually lower them with a secret, which lets you onto the rooftops. You can find lots of nice items for yourself. This is the chapel where we can pick up the rune, and once you've got this rune, you can run back to the centre of the map and exit. But we're not going to do that just yet because there's so much more stuff to find. Now the Jewel Shambler ambush here is pretty nasty. Again, this is a well-designed area, so there's lots of visibility blockers you can use. Kind of line of sight one Shambler while you're dealing with the other one. But it's still a pretty crazy fight. Then you're locked in here with them, it's yeah. I like that. And now we have to deal with the Horde of Zendar. Now this fight is an absolute joy to play. It starts off pretty easy. Again, this arena is fairly large, so you've got plenty of room to move around. Quite surprised that there weren't any crusher blocks involved in this fight. That seems to be a sock staple. But no, there aren't actually any in this map. But because you've got these giant pillars in the centre here that kind of block visibility throughout this entire outer ring, there's lots of opportunities for enemies to kind of build up in the corners and then kind of rush around. It's a really nicely designed arena. I just love the fact that you just have to keep constantly moving. There's lots of opportunities for monster infighting, as you might expect. It's very, very useful to do so on this map. I'd recorded so many demos where I'd actually died during this fight, which is kind of refreshing. I usually find that I don't really worry about dying too much in Quake maps these days, unless they're really, really hard, like a Tronin map or something. But Sock actually manages to make this combat fairly challenging, while still being fair. I'm trailing a lot of Vorballs here, so... Then you've got the Jewel Shambler just to cap it all off at the end. And again, you can use the pillars to line of sight them, which is really helpful. And now if you wanted to, you could just exit through the grate in the centre, which is now opened. But we're not going to do that just yet, because there's still loads of stuff to explore. Let's go and have a look. So we've got another secret button here which lowers the sides. And again, this is one way to access the rooftops. There's a... apparently there's just a way to climb up to the rooftops just by jumping. I haven't found it, I have no idea where it is. So apparently that's the thing, you can get up to the rooftops really early without needing to rocket jump or get the gold key. But yeah, I just haven't found that route yet, so I'm gonna have to keep searching. Well, obviously the rooftops are kind of cool because you can just access just about every single area of the map from up here. And there's another silver key door you can find with some lovely items in it and some secrets as well. Kind of wondering about that platform, there must be a way to activate it somewhere. Got a red armor there, and if you go to the other side, there is a silver key and silver key door which you can access, which gives you a lightning gun. I missed with all those rockets, but never mind. Sneaky knights, there's so many of them on this map. Just check every single corner before you go through it. I kind of like this ambush, because you have the Hell Knight come from around the corner as well. You have to kind of deal with them, but by shooting you awaken the Shambler. It's kind of really nice piece of design there. See how I kind of have to back away to where the Shambler won't hear you. Or you just have to deal with the Shambler and the Hell Knights right there. That's kind of cool, I thought. So that just about brings us to the end of this map. Now again, I haven't shown you everything here. There's more secrets to find. There's more enemies to kill. I definitely haven't found everything in this map yet, so I recommend you do have a good explore around, see what you can find that I missed. I know there is stuff, I've been told. So to exit, you can just go into the teleporter here, which brings you right back to the very start of the map where the skill select was, which I thought was kind of cute. Again, even if you come back down here, there's teleporters open, which will take you back up if you decide you did miss something. There we are, the Horde of Zendar. An absolutely fantastic map. If it's not the best Quake map ever made, it's certainly well up there in the top 10. I generally don't like to have favorites, but you can say something is definitely the absolute top echelon, I suppose. All right, let me know what you think in the comments, and I'll be finishing off Defendville very soon. See you next time.